Your Voice, I'm Julia Lilkindy. Today, Senator John Bonacic is with us to tell us what's happening in the New York State Senate. How are you, Senator?
Hey, Julia, but before I tell you what's happening in New York State Senate, let me tell you what's happening in Albany. We got a foot of snow out there.
Yeah.
This is Monday, and I came up last night to try to miss that, and it's been tough for people to commute here. But as long as they get here safe at some time in the day, it's a good thing.
Yes.
Just before I came on this show, we conducted a public hearing, mm-hmm. and we held a Senate Judiciary meeting on the appointment of two nominees that the governor has given us for the Court of Appeals. Right now, the Court of Appeals should consist of 7 judges, and there are 5. So there were 2 vacancies. Judge Graffio left after serving 14 years, and Judge Smith left, who retired out because when you reach age 70, it's mandatory retirement. You can't serve beyond that. And in their places, the governor gave us Judge Stein, who's from Albany. She had 19 years judicial experience. Close to 6 or 7 in the Supreme Court and about a like amount as an appellate division judge. And Judge Fahey, similar 19 years judicial experience with 6 years in the Supreme Court, 8 years on the appellate division from Buffalo. So these are certainly experienced judges and they've come up the judicial ladder at every level. So in my opinion, they were the governor gave us qualified nominees. It passed the Senate Judiciary Committee, both nominees, unanimously. Huh. And when I leave this show, we will go in the Senate chambers to confirm them. And tomorrow, they will go over to Albany there and sit on the Court of Appeals, because that's another term of cases coming up, to then make it 7.
Get right back to work.
Right back to it. And it's interesting to see the dynamics of the Judiciary Committee. You have some there talking about the Garner case and how they're apt to rule. Some talked about the SAFE Act and how they're apt to rule. And naturally, they can't talk about how they would rule when those issues come before them. And what they normally say is, we will be open, we will be fair, we will apply the law, we will apply the U.S. and the state constitution. That's their formal answer, which is the only thing they can do. But I asked about independence from the governor, if there's ever a matter that comes before them, governor versus legislature. Will they be beholden to the governor and just rule his way? I asked about fracking. When that comes before them, will they just embrace what the administration said, or will they look to the Constitution and look what other states are doing? So there was a variety of questions, and a Senate asked about racial profiling. So all of the members of the judiciary, whatever their political and philosophical persuasion is, they try to get the judge's ear to see how they might lean if and when those issues come before them. But the vote was unanimous as a testament to both judges, and they will have no problem on the floor this afternoon being confirmed.
So the way it goes is the governor nominates and then the Senate confirms.
That's correct.